Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. Today I would like to discuss whether the era of the megapixel wars is truly over for camera manufacturers. I hope you find this topic interesting and join me on this journey. How did the megapixel wars begin? Around 2001 to 2002, the manufacturers went from 2-3 megapixels to 8-10 megapixels within a few years. This was a significant leap in development. By 2007, they had reached 12 megapixels, constantly trying to outdo each other. Back then, having a higher resolution was a clear advantage, as it made images appear finer even with the presence of image noise. Of course, it made a difference whether you were viewing a 2-megapixel image scaled down on an old 1024x768 monitor or resizing a 5x10-megapixel image with software. The advantage also extended to printing photos on paper. In 2012, Nikon introduced the Nikon D3200, the company's first 24-megapixel APS-C sensor DSLR camera. Higher-end models followed suit with the same resolution. Canon, on the other hand, had 18 megapixels in their entry and lower mid-range cameras and 20 megapixels in their mid-range and upper mid-range models like the EOS 70D. Numerically, there is a significant difference between 24 megapixels and 20 megapixels, but in practice, the difference is minimal. A 20% resolution advantage exists for the 24 megapixel camera over the 20 megapixel one, but even the latter is sufficient for a 300 dpi print at a width of 45 centimeters, while the 24 megapixel allows for a width of 50 centimeters. Finally, in 2019, Canon reclaimed the lead in the APS-C segment with the EOS 90D, offering a resolution of 32 megapixels. Among Micro Four Thirds cameras, 16 megapixels remained the peak resolution for a long time, with both Olympus and Panasonic staying at this level for years. Then in 2015, Panasonic stepped up to 20 megapixels with the Lumix GX8. Olympus followed suit a year later in 2016 with the Pen F, which also offered 20 megapixels. This 20 megapixel resolution remained for several years until Panasonic released the GH6 with 25 megapixels this year, marking a change after a gap of 5 years. In the realm of full-frame sensor cameras, Canon held the top position for years with its EOS 5DS and EOS 5DSR DSLRs, which offered 50 megapixels from 2015 onwards. Nikon caught up in 2018 with the 45.7-megapixel Nikon Z7, and Panasonic followed suit in 2019 with the 47.3-megapixel S1R mirrorless full-frame cameras. In 2020, Canon introduced the EOS R5, featuring the highest resolution for a full-frame mirrorless camera at 47 megapixels. This brought it on par with the Nikon Z7. A year earlier, in 2019, Sony released the Alpha 7 R4, boasting approximately 61 megapixels. Currently, this is considered the highest resolution among full-frame mirrorless cameras. This year, Leica also launched the M11 with a 60-megapixel full-frame CMOS sensor. This is where camera manufacturers stand in terms of megapixels, and there are already rumors about Sony's upcoming full-frame camera with around 100 megapixels and Canon's preparation for a high-resolution model rumored to have 75 megapixels. So, considering all this, would the era of the megapixel wars truly come to an end? Many believe so, as the highest-resolution cameras have remained at roughly the same megapixel count for years. Manufacturers could certainly produce cameras with higher megapixel counts, but the market has not yet fully embraced this. Moreover, why would one need a resolution higher than around 50 megapixels? It ultimately depends on the user's needs. For a 70x47cm print at 300 dpi, 47 megapixels is already sufficient. But there was a time when someone said 640 kilobytes of memory would be enough for everyone. However, despite the apparent slowdown of the wars, I believe it is somewhat illusory. Yes, the highest resolution cameras mostly offer the same resolution as years ago. However, from another perspective, the availability and prevalence of high resolution options in the market have never been greater. The prices of high megapixel cameras are decreasing. It's not just the used market. New DSLRs and mirrorless cameras with high resolution are less expensive than ever. But most companies are gradually phasing out low-resolution models. Achieving 8K video requires sensors with increasingly higher resolutions. Therefore, in my opinion, the megapixel wars are still ongoing, albeit in a slightly different form than before. What are your thoughts on this? Leave a comment below. Thank you for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, please like and follow our channel for more content in the future.